This week on 60 Minutes, that.
Gelding the Dollar burst into the open on March 19th, and the fireworks haven't stopped since. It's rare an eruption lasts this long, and rarer still for this southwest corner of Iceland. This is the first eruption in 800 years. Only 20 miles from the capital, scientists have scrambled to get here. The easy access is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to collect data that is often lost at more hazardous or remote eruptions. Chris Hamilton is an associate professor of planetary sciences at the University of Arizona. Unlike other scientists trying to unlock the secrets of the Earth, Hamilton's interest goes far beyond this planet.
Your eye is really on Mars. So why Iceland?
All of the different terrestrial bodies in the solar system, be it Mars or our moon, have volcanic landforms, volcanic terrains. The landscape here with relatively barren vegetation is very similar to what we see in the Martian environment. And so when we have a chance to study a new eruption like this, it really helps us to understand the history of Mars. And in fact, Mars has the tallest volcano in the solar system, Olympus Mons. Absolutely glorious volcano. These types of volcanic edifices are so large that we can only study them using satellites. And in some cases, we can then send a rover or a lander or most recently a drone with Ingenuity to be able to study them on the surface.
You may have seen pictures of NASA's Ingenuity that took flight on Mars this April, a world first. Hamilton has a $3 million grant from NASA to develop the next generation drone that he hopes will help decode the red planet. It's called RAVEN, which stands for Rover Aerial Vehicle Exploration Network.
How does Iceland help you with that?
So Iceland offers an analog. It offers some similarities to understanding planetary landscapes like Mars. And so we can test different instruments and different science operation workflows to be able to make sure that we pick the right tools and know how to use them when we send a mission to Mars or Moon or another body in the solar system.
If all goes according to plan, RAVEN will go further, working with a rover by flying ahead of it and sending data back to its four-wheeled boss to generate 3D maps. It will also have a claw that can retrieve Martian rocks and deliver them to the rover.
The drone has completely revolutionized the way that we do field work. It can be a scout and it can provide a tremendous perspective on your environment. And in fact, most of the time when we're looking at satellite images, drones act like personal satellites that give us a bird's eye view of our environment. And so what are you going to use that provides the best science return? It could be a camera, it could be a laser, it could be a drill, it could be different types of technology.
You want to have a claw on it, I understand.
Yeah, certainly as a geologist, what is one of my wishes? To be able to fetch a sample. So if I wanted to be able to get a sample from over there, walking over the lava would be very challenging, but if you could send a drone with a claw or a drill to be able to acquire a sample and bring it back to a rover, that provides a radically new paradigm for being able to explore the really rugged parts of Mars that we haven't been able to get to on the ground.
Joanna Voigt is a PhD candidate at the University of Arizona's Lunar and Planetary Laboratory. She's been working with Hamilton on the RAVEN project, mapping the lava flow with laser scanners and drones.
So what are you seeing right now?
So right now I'm right above the lava pond.
And we've got the whole river of
yes.
Lava.
And it's starting to crest over. We measure velocities.
Oh, you're measuring the speed of the flow of the
correct.
Lava?
Yes.
So what does this tell you about Mars?
So I'm interested in understanding what the morphology, so the structure of the lava, can tell you. By just looking onto the old deposits on Mars, we can then use that for modeling to correlate that.
Hamilton's team will continue to develop instruments for the RAVEN. They hope to test a prototype in 2022 in Iceland. Where else?